Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your Daily Market Outlook for Thursday, May 7th, 2009. This is my only presentation this morning. Running out of time and I have an appointment this morning, so Stock Market Timing Television will be back on Friday morning. Looking at the pre-market this morning, futures are above fair value. Both gold and crude oil are up in the pre-market, so we are looking for some buying at the open on Thursday morning. Now, it's been exciting last couple of days. We've seen panic buying at its best. This is certainly the end of an up move, not the start of an up move, even though that's what a lot of people think. We now have hit our upside target of 10,000, which was our target off the 7,500 lows. So that should be about all she wrote for now. We're still waiting for the breakdown, of course. This is panic buying. Remember, we use the panic zone charts to highlight irrational behavior. At the bottom, we look for panic selling. We put the pressure zones there to help reinforce that that's the time and place you should look to be a buyer. That's the low-risk time and place to enter the market. When we punch through the top of the panic zones, of course, that's panic buying. If you own something up here, you should be standing on your desk cheering, drinking champagne. This is happy time. Certainly, it is not the time and place to be jumping in the market. Now, right now, we've made that move up, the two lines off the 7,500 low. You know, this time last year, we did exactly the same thing. We moved up from 12,500 to 15,000. That was a two-line move. It did similar things that put a lot of pressure on people. Here's the current flypaper channel and with our market thermometer indicator at the bottom. Off the March lows here, we've run up and we've been overbought for what seems like just a lifetime now. But that isn't unprecedented. It's happened many times before and it'll always unwind. Here's the same chart, but going back exactly 1 year, one of the things you'll notice is back in late 2007, we had a similar situation where we were overbought for what seemed like an enormous amount of time. And of course, then the market started to fall apart. And right now we're looking at, there's the March lows of 2008, ran up, became overbought, of course. And a similar situation. What was different about that particular run-up and what we're seeing now is we did get a couple of pullbacks. There's one here. If you move the chart forward another month, we had another pullback. Those are two, you know, entry points people could have got in. It certainly would have been very hard to get in up here as we were printing all 8, 9s, and 10s, and we're up definitely up at the top of the panic zones, testing the 15,000 area. We put in a double top. Finally, after putting in a double top, we had a third attempt and that failed. We didn't even get up to the previous highs, which alerted us to the fact the market had run out of steam and we were looking for lower prices. And then finally, the market started to break down, formed another pressure zone, which would have been another low risk buying opportunity. So, you know, what's happening right now is not unprecedented. A two-line move to the upside is not unprecedented. Being overbought for this length of time is not unprecedented. Of course, they always unwind and will give us another low-risk buying opportunity in the not-so-distant future. I am bullish as long as the weekly weekly charts stay on a buy signal. I remain bullish no matter what the economic outlook is. Now, talking about, you know, buying the dips, I've been showing the hourly flypaper channel because that's what people have been doing. Every time we've come down to that flypaper channel, people have been buying those dips. And so, you know, if you're watching the market using monthly charts, then you would go to the weekly charts and buy the dips on the weekly charts to add to a monthly position. If you're using the weekly charts to manage your money, then of course we'd be waiting for a daily dip. If you wanted to add to a position, so if the market comes down over a couple of weeks and then starts to move back up on the daily charts. The move down over a couple of weeks wasn't enough to affect the weekly charts. And then you buy the next buy signal on the daily charts. That's how you continue to add to a position or get into a market that you're not already in. And similarly, if you're watching the charts using, if you're watching the market using daily charts, of course, you can buy the dips on the hourly charts. And that's what we've been reinforcing last couple of weeks, because that's what people have been doing. It's pretty obvious that the market's been coming back down to the hourly flypaper channel, and people have been buying those dips. Now, looking at the next move, of course, we're waiting to finally get kicked out of the rest of our bullish positions in the Horizon Beta Pro ETFs. And when that happens, we're going to be buying the bearish ETFs. This is the energy sector. Here's financials, still doing very well, waiting to get into those financial bears. Not that we're bearish on the market, but markets go up, markets go down. We want to try to make money on both sides. Here's the gold ETF, gave a buy signal and early warning signal yesterday. I'm going to ignore that for the time being. I'm not that bullish on gold. Gold is up in the pre-market on Thursday, so it might be something I miss. I just don't think the upside potential is that great at the moment. Looking at the bear ETF, now an early warning signal yesterday. To the downside, here's the TSX bull ETF, certainly still mimicking the market, of course, which is doing very well. And there's the bear ETF, and we're interested in buying that when the time is right. One of the other Horizon Beta Pro ETFs we've been watching, this is the bear ETF on the 30-year long bond, U.S. long bond, and money is still flowing out of bonds, but it appears to have stopped. Right down at the bottom here, you can see we've been unable to make new lows for the past few days. So this is, you know, this is the safety trade. Right now, money is flowing out of bonds, as you can see. Bond prices are falling. If that changes, then that would help confirm that money is flowing out of stocks back into bonds. Bonds is the safety trade. And if we start to see a buy signal in bonds, that could help reinforce a down signal in the stock market itself. Taking a look at RIM, remember when we had the big pop-up, I recommended taking some profits back here. And, you know, anytime that you take profits, that doesn't mean you liquidate your position. You should always have something left and let the market kick you out of a trade. Whether you want to do quarter, 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 third, 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 half, half, whatever, however you want to break up your trade, depending on how many shares you bought and what you're paying for brokerage fees, it's quite important that you let the market finally kick you out. And so if you want to lock in some profits, you know, there's nothing wrong with doing that. I like to do that. I like to ring the cash register a few times throughout a trade and then finally wait for the market to kick me out. Now, we used RIM as an example of what happens when you trade a stock and then, you know, you feel something's changed and now you want it more as an investment than a trade. So right now on the right side chart, we're looking at a breakdown point of 84. A daily close below 84 would kick us out of this stock. If you move to the midterm chart right now, we need a daily close of 80. So if you wanted to give it a little bit more room to breathe and you're thinking of holding it longer or trying to hold it longer, and in fact, if you know, you want to hold it for a much longer period of time, the weekly charts are currently saying that a weekly close below 70 would kick us out. This number, of course, is going to move up this Friday. This weekend it'll probably be $72, $73. This coming Friday, as RIM has moved up this week. But that's how, you know, if you use the right side chart as a trade to get in and the trade starts to move up and you learn more about the company and things have changed, it's not the same company you knew before and you want to go from a trade to an investment, then, you know, you need to wean yourself off the right side chart and move to the daily midterm or start to move to the weekly right side. And then from the weekly right side, if over a couple of months you're still in the trade, you can move to the weekly intermediate term chart and use that as your method of managing that particular trade that has now become an investment. Okay, looking at the hourly charts for Thursday for the TSX, we need an hourly close below 9,990 to give us a new intraday sell signal on Thursday. We're going to look for support at the 9,600 level. The bulls are still in command. If we continue to trade above 9,600, a breakdown below 9,600 would tell us that the bears are now in control. Looking at the energy sector, an hourly close below 257 on Thursday would give us a new intraday sell signal. We're looking for a breakdown below 245. If we start breaking down below 245, we would assume that the bears have taken control of the energy sector. Looking at financial stocks, we need an hourly close below 145 on Thursday. 137 is our breakdown point. Below that, we would assume that the bears have taken control of the Canadian financial sector on an intraday basis, looking at gold stocks, an hourly close below 295 would kick us out on Thursday, and we would assume that the bears are back in control of the gold sector if we start closing below 290 on Thursday. Now, a couple of things that could cause this market to peak out right now. We're back at a couple of the highs that we saw back in October and November, and that could act as resistance right now. We also have a full moon coming on the 9th this weekend, and that, of course, could be a pivot point to put pressure on the stock market to change direction. So just a couple of things to note. Of course, you don't need to do anything about those until we actually see evidence that they're taking place. But when you're creating a roadmap for the market, you need to know where the possible turns are ahead of time, and that's what we're looking at. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.